Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you a number of different ways to save battery or increase battery life on a Windows 11 laptop. The method should work on any laptop running Windows 11, although the performance might differ depending on each laptop. You don't necessarily need to follow all of the methods to save battery, so feel free to skip any, but the more methods you do, the longer your battery should last. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. We'll begin with a quick test to see if there are any power issues that could be causing our battery to drain quicker. To do this, we're going to run the Power Troubleshooter. This can be done by first going to the main settings page, and once in there, click on System from the options on the left side, although you should be in there by default. In the system settings, click on Troubleshoot and then choose Other Troubleshooters. Now look down the list for the troubleshooter called Power and click on Run next to it. Allow Windows to look for and suggest any possible solutions that might help. The next method is to turn on Power Saver mode in the Power settings. This is different to Battery Saver mode as it will run all of the time. You shouldn't notice too much of a performance difference, but there should be an increase in your battery life as your components won't be working as hard. To change the Power settings to Power Saver mode, you need to go to the Control Panel first. You can get there by searching for it in the search bar. In the Control Panel, click on System and Security, and then choose Power Options from the list. In the Power Settings, you might need to click on Show Additional Plans to get the Power Saver option. Check the box to the left of Power Saver to turn it on. You can always choose Balanced if you are already on High Performance, so you don't lose too much performance while still saving battery. If you click on Change Plan Settings, you can edit the time your PC will stay on. You will be able to change the options for both when on power and when on battery. Feel free to change these, and the shorter the time is, the more you will save your battery when you are away from your laptop. Whilst we're in the power settings, we'll move on to the third method. You can skip this one if you like, if you don't feel comfortable in changing some of these settings. If you are still in the Edit Plan Settings page of the Power Saver mode we selected, then click on Change Advanced Power Settings to open a new window. In these advanced settings, first find the option called Sleep and click on it to expand it. There are a few more options that we can change in here, such as turning on Hibernate. Now find the option called Processor Power Management and expand it, and expand the option called Maximum Processor State. You should see two options, with one that says On Battery. Feel free to change this number to something like 80% initially on battery. This will limit your processor to 80% and will save battery, but you will lose some performance obviously, especially when running demanding programs, so if it's not worth it then you can return to here to change it back to 100%. If you find that 80% doesn't make much of a difference to the performance, then you could even go lower to save more battery. Remember to click Apply to save any changes that you've made. Leave this window open as we're going to focus on brightness next. Find the option called Display and click on it to expand it. You should see more options than me, but find the one called Enable Adaptive Brightness and expand that. If you want to, you can turn it on for when your laptop is on battery. If you don't like adaptive brightness, then if you leave it off, you can change the brightness in the Power Plan Settings screen, which was the page we were on before this window opened, and it should still be open in the Control Panel. You can change the brightness for both when on power and also when using the battery. The fifth method to save battery on your Windows 11 laptop is to prevent certain apps from running when you start up your PC. Not only will these apps cause your PC to take longer to start up, but they will run in the background, which will result in your laptop having to do more work than necessary. To view and disable startup programs, you first need to go to the Task Manager. You can get there by right-clicking on the Start Menu button at the bottom, and then by choosing Task Manager. In the Task Manager, find the Startup tab, and now you should see the list of programs that can automatically start when you turn on your laptop. You'll need to go down the list and look for any programs you know you don't use, or those that you don't use regularly. Disabling them in here won't make them stop working, however they might take a bit longer to run when you want to use them. But of course, if you don't use them that often, this won't make too much difference. To disable an application in here, all you need to do is right-click on it, and then choose Disable. It's helpful to look at the Startup Impact column to help make your decision on whether it's worth disabling them. You can always enable the program again by right-clicking on it and selecting Enable. Again, whilst we're in the Task Manager, you can also save battery by closing any programs you aren't currently using. It's helpful to check which use the most system resources in the Processes tab by looking at the CPU and GPU column. Also, look in the Background Processes section for apps that you don't use, but don't end the task for any programs you don't recognize, as they might be system services. You might find things like your browser run in the background, and this will use battery. The seventh method to save battery on your laptop is to make sure Bluetooth is turned off if you have it, as well as turning off Wi-Fi when not using it. Although this might be rare, if you really need to save battery, turning these off will definitely help. Thankfully, in Windows 11, it's easy to turn off Bluetooth. All you need to do is go to the main settings page, which can be accessed by searching for it. In the settings, you can turn off Bluetooth in the Bluetooth and devices section, and you can turn Wi-Fi off in the network and internet section. The next method is quite simple. All you need to do is unplug any peripheral devices from your laptop, if you have any, when you are not using them. Any device, such as a wired mouse or USB stick, might draw unnecessary power from your laptop's battery, so if you keep them unplugged when not in use, you should see a slight increase in battery life. Method 9 is to free up space on your device. If your device is close to capacity, it might run slower and therefore use more battery. Freeing up space could also help make your laptop run more efficiently. Check out my channel or click the card on screen now, as I'll have videos that cover many ways to free up space in Windows. A few quick ways to free up space would be to empty the recycle bin, which can be done by right-clicking on it. You could sort through your downloads folder or uninstall a program you no longer use. You can uninstall a program by going to Settings, then Apps and Features, and then finding the app you want to uninstall, and then finally click on the three dots icon and choose Uninstall. The 10th and final method to save battery life is to physically clean your laptop, and especially the vents. The cooler your laptop can run, the less the fans will be required and the more efficient it will be, extending your battery life. And so those are my methods to help save battery and increase battery life on a Windows 11 laptop. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you how to improve the sound quality of your headphones in Windows. Help support the channel by visiting the store. The link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.